We'll study parallel strip line. Now consider the parallel strip lines. Here, as the name indicates, we are having two conducting plates. So this is one conducting plate and this is another conducting plate. So these two conducting plates are separated by a dielectric materials. And instead, whatever these particular dotted lines have been shown, so these are the dielectric materials. And this one is a conducting plates. That means it looks like a two parallel wires are separated by a dielectric materials. And so the width of this particular conducting plates is W. The same figure shown in this. So here you have one conducting plates, and at the bottom one you have another conducting plates. The structure looks like this. This is one conducting plate and this is another conducting plates. In between this, so we are having the dielectric materials. And here also, the type of the mode possible is, because we are sending the micro signals through these particular strip lines, quasi TEM mode is possible. And for this parallel strip lines, if W is greater than D, Then fringing capacitance, if W is greater than D, then the fringing capacitance becomes negligible or the value is very small. Now try to calculate the various parameters such as resistance, inductance, capacitance and all other values in order to analyze the performance of these strip lines. The inductance along conducting strip line is, the inductance along conducting strip line means, as this is a conducting plate and this is a conducting plate, it contains some amount of the inductance, so that inductance we are supposed to calculate it. So that is given by L equal to mu C into D, so divided by W Henry per meter, where this mu C is equal to permeability of the conductor. Mu C is the permeability of the conductor, means whatever these conducting plates are there, so they have some amount of the permeability, that permeability is mu C. Okay, we'll call it as equation number one. The series resistance is so this is a conductor and this is a conductors. It contains some amount of the resistance, and the series resistance of this conductor is both the strips is 2 into RS, so divided by, so W, so this is equal to 2 by W into root of pi F into mu C, so divided by rho into C, ohms per meter, where your RS is equal to surface resistance and rho C is equal to conductivity of the strip. So these plates are having certain conductivity, so that conductivity we are calling it as a conductivity of the strip, represented by rho C. Next, the shunt conductance of parallel strip line, the shunt conductance of parallel strip line is G equal to rho into D divided by D mu per meter. We will call it as equation number 4, where rho into D is equal to conductivity of dielectric material between the strip. Next, we will calculate characteristic impedance. Characteristic impedance is represented by Z0. Characteristic impedance is equal to root of L by C. So this can also be calculated from D divided by W into root of mu R into mu C divided by E0 into ERD. So this is equal to 377. So divided by root of ERD into D divided by W to ohms. So we'll call it as equation number 5. Then, so the phase velocity of TEM mode propagating through the parallel strip line is Vp is equal to omega divided by beta. So this is equal to 1 by root of L into C, and this can also be calculated from the equation. Okay, Vp is equal to omega divided by beta equal to 1 by root of LC, and this can also be calculated by 1 by root of mu 0 into mu r, epsilon 0 into epsilon rd. And this can also be calculated from C divided by epsilon rd. We will call it as equation number 6. Now, let us calculate the attenuation loss. At microwave frequency, the propagation constant is gamma is equal to root of z into y, and substitute the values of z and substitute the values of y. So z is equal to root of r plus j omega l, and y is equal to c plus j omega c. Now, for r is less than omega l and g is less than omega c, for these conditions, let us try to simplify this. For r is less than omega l and g is less than omega c, so this equation becomes gamma is equal to 1 by 2 into r of root of c by l plus g into root of l by c plus j omega c. Now, so this equation we will call it as alpha plus j beta. This is a real part and this is an imaginary part. Now, compare real part, then alpha equal to 1 by 2 r into root of c by l plus g into root of l by c. Okay. Then compare imaginary parts, then beta equal to, for r is less than omega l and g is less than omega c, then so this equation becomes 1 by 2 into r root of c by l plus g into root of l by c plus j omega into root of l c. So this I can write it as alpha plus j beta. Then compare, so this equation with respect to this, that is compare the real parts. If I compare the real part, so this is the real part what we are having. So if this is the real part and here this is the real part, therefore I can write alpha is equal to 1 by 2 r into root of c by l plus g into root of l by c. And so this is the imaginary part and here this is the imaginary part. So therefore beta is equal to omega into root of lc. And so this is the equation used to calculate the attenuation constant, and this is the equation which is used to calculate the phase constant. Then from this equation we will try to get few more values. The attenuation constant for conductor losses is given by alpha c equal to 1 by 2 r into root of c by l. Okay, and this equation is nothing but, so the first term in this particular equation. So this equation is nothing but the first term in this equation. Substitute the values of r, l and c from equation number 1, 2 and 3 in the equation alpha c. Substitute values of r, l and c in the equation for alpha c. Then alpha c equal to 1. If we substitute the values, then we will get this particular equation and then try to simplify this. 1 by 2 into 2 by omega into root of pi f mu c divided by rho into c into root of epsilon d into omega square, so divided by d into mu c into d. So this is equal to this 2 and this 2 will go. And this omega and this omega will go, and this mu c and this mu c will go. Okay, then it becomes 1 by 2 into 2 by omega into root of pi f divided by rho c into root of epsilon d, so divided by d square. Then, so this equation simplifies to, so d square, a square root is there, so then it becomes d, so I will take it outside, so then it is root of pi f epsilon d, so divided by rho c. So this is equal to your alpha c. And this is measured in Napier's per meter. Now, call it as equation number 9. And attenuation constant for dielectric loss is, take the second term from the given equation, alpha d is equal to, here also, substitute the values of L, C and G. Again, substitute values of L, C and G. If you substitute the values of L, C and G, then now, the attenuation constant for a dielectric loss is given by alpha d is equal to g by 2 into root of c by l. In this equation, substitute the values of l, c and g. The equation becomes this. Then, after cancelling the terms, so this equation simplifies to alpha d is equal to 1 by 2 rho d into root of mu 0 into mu 2 divided by epsilon 0 into epsilon d. So this equation becomes 1 by 2 into rho d into root of 1 by epsilon r d with mu c equal to 1. Here, mu 0 and mu c, so these are the permeabilities, and epsilon 0 and epsilon d are the permittivity. Then, so this alpha d is equal to 1.88 rho d divided by epsilon r d, and it is measured in nepers per meter. And this is how you can calculate the various parameters. Now, we'll solve one numeric problem. Example, a lossless parallel strip line has copper conducting strip each of width 18 mm, separated by a quartz dielectric of dielectric constant 3.8 having thickness of 2.5 mm. The conductivity of copper is 5.8 into 10 to the power of 7 mho per meter, and that of quartz is 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 mho per meter. The frequency of operation is 12 gigahertz. Calculate characteristic impedance phase velocity of propagating wave strip line inductance strip line capacitance series resistance of both strips, shunt conductance of dielectric, attenuation conductor of attenuation constant of conductor, attenuation constant of dielectric losses. Okay, these are the 8 parameters you are supposed to calculate. First, write down whatever the given values are there, and then try to calculate all the values. Solution. First, write the given values. The given values are width is equal to 18 mm, epsilon rd is equal to 3.8, t is equal to 2.5 mm, f is equal to 12 gigahertz, rho c equal to 5.8 into 10 to the power of minus 7 mho per meter, and rho d is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 mho per meter. So these are the values are given. Characteristic impedance. Impedance Z0 is calculated by this equation, and in this equation substitute so the given values. Okay. And ERD is given, so that is 3.8. And D value is given as 2.5 mm and W value is given as 18 mm. That is 2.5 so divided by 18. Okay. And this one gives a value equal to 26.86 ohms. The phase velocity is Vp. Okay, it is given by c, phase velocity is given by c divided by root of epsilon rd. So this is equal to c is the velocity of light, epsilon rd is given in the problem. That is 3 into 10 to the power of 10, so divided by root of epsilon rd. Epsilon rd value is given as 3.8. So this is equal to 1.5 into 10 to the power of 8 meter per second. Next, strip line inductance L is given by L equal to L equal to mu c into d divided by w. So this mu c you can write it as mu 0 into mu rc into d divided by w. So in this equation, substitute all the values and try to get the L. In this equation, go on substituting the values and try to simplify. Where mu 0 is equal to 4.2 10 to the power of minus 7 and mu rc is equal to 1, and the values of d is given, it is 2.5 mm, that is 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. We will try to convert it into meters, and then w is given 18 mm, so then 18 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Then the simplification of this will give you a value 0.175 microhenry per meter. Next, we'll calculate strip line capacitance C. C is equal to epsilon d into W, so divided by d, where this epsilon d is equal to epsilon 0 into epsilon r d into W divided by d. So in this equation, substitute all the values, where epsilon 0 is equal to 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12, and this is the standard values. And epsilon r d is given, so that is equal to 3.8. And W, so the width is given, it is 18 mm. So 18 into 10 to the power of 3, we are converting into meters. And then divided by d, so the d value is given as 2.5, and that also will convert into meters. So therefore, it is multiplied by 10 to the power of minus 3. So the simplification of this is going to give us the value 242.25 picofarads per meter. Then the series resistance is given by is calculated by the series reactance is calculated by the equation R is equal to 2 divided by W into root of pi f into mu c divided by rho c. So this 2 by W, will write it as root of pi into f, whatever is mu into c is there, that is permeability of conductor. You can replace it by mu 0 into mu r c, so divided by rho into c. And then in this equation, we'll go on substituting the values and to try to get the values of R. Write as is, 2 we will write it as it is, then W is equal to 18 into 10 to the power of minus 3 pi mu 0 value is equal to 12 into 10 to the power of 9, mu RC value is equal to 4.2 10 to the power of minus 7, so divided by 5.8 into 10 to the power of 7, and we will simplify this and get the values of R. The simplified value of this becomes 3.176 mho per meter. So this is your value of R. Now, next calculate the shunt conductance. The shunt conductance of dielectric substrate G equal to GD into W divided by D. This is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4 into 18 into 10 to the power of minus 3, so divided by 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. This gives a value of 1.44 into 10 to the power of minus 3. That is mho per meter. So this is the value of your shunt conductance. Next, we will calculate the attenuation constant for a conductor loss, that is alpha c equal to 1 by d into root of mu f epsilon d divided by rho into c. Substitute all the values and try to get the values of alpha c. alpha c equal to 1 by d into root of pi f epsilon d divided by rho c. D is equal to 2.5 into 10 to the power of minus 3. Pi we are writing as it is. F is equal to 12 into 10 to the power of 9. Epsilon d is equal to 8.854 into 10 to the power of minus 12. So divided by 5.8 into 10 to the power of 7. So this gives the value of 0.06 nepers per meter. So this is the values of alpha c. Next we will calculate the attenuation constant for dielectric loss, that is alpha d is equal to alpha d is equal to 188 rho d divided by root of epsilon r d. So in this equation, substitute all the values. Rho d is equal to 2 into 10 to the power of minus 4. Epsilon r d is equal to 3.8. If you simplify it, so you will get the values as 0.02 nepers per meter. So this is how you can calculate the various parameters of the strip line.